We've seen major success from his Chun-Li play in online tournaments in Europe, and that's the play. That's kind of the biggest reason to go with Chun-Li, aka Mushang, Epic Crossover.
The down gauntlets?
The down gauntlet, it's a true combo off of neutral light at low damage.
Whoa, really?
Yeah, what the heck?
I didn't know that.
Well,
that's tech.
Maybe want some more tournaments. Bro.
Oh, bro, you think maybe if the casters called out stuff like that more often, I'd know.
Maybe if our casters were more knowledgeable.
A snake eating its own tail.
If we talked about the gameplay more instead of just.
But you look at the gameplay right now, Moon here. Absolutely running away with the first stock. Everything happened.
You
got the gravity cancel, down light into recovery, showing his depth of skill with this weapon. He is looking phenomenal against PR rank one in North America, Luna, so far in game one. This is an excellent performance. He needs to push this advantage, though. He's getting closer to that knockout range. He's in a bad position. He could get KO'd at any time now, especially against these gauntlets of Luna.
This has been the curse of Mounir in this event, is playing so well, getting a huge lead, and then it gets equalized on him pretty quickly.
Yeah.
That's rough, because this could have gone the other way, right? I mean, once you're in neutral, you're in neutral. It doesn't matter how much damage you had on you before, the next neutral is
almost enough to do it.
He's
in a bad position. Mounir, low options.
He's still good. Dodges the weapon, though. Can he make it back? Oh, he dodges the ground pound. He's a beast.
Woo.
He's got to get back to the, oh my gosh.
Dude,
he ran. He was literally out of recovery option.
Yeah.
He got back to the floor just in time.
That was a buzzer beater. Finally able to tack on some extra credit damage on the second stock, but actually, extra credit, they're on the same stock. More time to fool around. Yeah, you're right. If only our casters were paying attention, they'd see that Luna now dominant lead here in game one. He's got the final stock primed and ready. He's coming away with this scythe, and he is going to piece away at this stock from Mounir.
We're only 2 minutes into the fight before they got to a final stock situation. It's the intensity of this matchup is insane. That's something you would do.
What are you talking about? What do you mean?
Don't act like you haven't just raw.
Oh my gosh.
Raw gauntlet down sig in the middle of the stage when nobody was near you.
This coming from a Thea spammer is rich, honestly.
Yeah, don't
really
do that.
Uh-oh, Luna.
What?
This could be it.
Oh, he made it. He made it. What a play. Mounir wave underneath the stage.
I like
comes
that.
Comes away with his life and a knockout. What a play.
He had the one extra move there with the weapon. The weapon throw wasn't needed, but would have actually. It could have come into play. He was playing to the whistle there. That was amazing. But he has so little health in this final stock.
Yeah.
Can he pull up?
He's got to play a perfect final stock here.
Well,
I was going to say one more recovery.
One more recovery was it. Game
all right,
one.
All right. Luna takes game one, but Mounir was looking good throughout that game. I think he could take the set, man. I think. Wrong? Luna.
That's a bold prediction from,
Luna's got a problem.
Mounir's like, good, perfect.
He just wanted his sweater. He's cold. That's all.
He just
wanted to warm up.
I mean,
up
ice in those veins the way he took out that
ice
first game. I mean, obviously he needs a sweatshirt
to warm
up. That was
cold-blooded. He's cold-blooded.
What the heck is this, dude? What is happening in that room right now?
If it were me, I'd be sweating.
After game one, me and you are both sweating, and they're both like, cold? I'm cold. How is this even happening? This is how.
We're literally sweating right now.
This is how cold of operators these two players are. They literally.
Maybe that's what it takes.
Their heartbeat isn't even elevated. they need to be warmed up.
They're so cold blooded.
Oh, man. Okay.
Oh,
well,
my goodness.
Let's see if we can witness a big change here in game two, because Mounir needs to come away with this to keep himself in the set, because going down 2-0 against Luna, that is just an impossible task to come over.
We've got the same legend selections. Wait, or do we? Wait a second. Is that a Tigress I see underneath? There's no way Luna just switched to Asuri, right?
No, that is a prank
it's
on you.
It's because of the Kung Fu Panda crossover. It's just a little bit of... Okay. And then Mounir switched to Taros. Wait, you're going Taros against Luna? Are you crazy?
You're right. One of the most premier Taros players on the planet. But maybe there's something he hasn't seen yet before. The immediate weapon grab in the neutral light.
Mounir did do really good on Taros in his last game. So let's see.
Ooh, and he's catching some damage here so far, keeping it close. Too early to tell. But
nice.
I'm liking this Taros pick. he's very fluid with the movements. He's picking up lots. He's not landing one hit. He's landing two. He's landing three, and that can pay dividends with the high force legend like Taros.
With that amount of strength, like two hits. Oh, that's
and that's it.
That's it. Oh, okay. Man, a pretty early lead from Munir. Okay, so we talked about this before.
Yeah.
But every time Munir gets a lead at this Royale, it gets equalized on him rather quickly. If you can build up a damage lead, which he's already on his way to doing, this could be the ticket to victory. He's a full stock ahead now, Steven. He's looking good.
Now, I'm almost thinking that I'm predicting.
Shut up. Whatever you were about to say just happened, I'm pretty sure.
No, I was actually going to predict that we're going to see double Taros in game three, but that was maybe too bold because
you
still.
Said it sooner.
I was trying, but then you stopped. You told me to shut up. Everybody, I'm being gaslit. I don't know what gaslighting is, but I'm pretty sure we're witnessing it here. All right, second stock for each player, but. Munir still pushing the advantage. He has a chance for the corner guard here. No, Luna makes it back up on top.
Oh, he's so damaged. Oh, oh my gosh.
This juggles.
Okay, he is.
That was a heinous juggle from the Axe of Munir.
Stomp Sider will definitely do any, almost any hit with this hammer. A neutral air? Oh, no.
Okay. You know what?
An unfortunate miss, but he cleaned it cleaned it up right after.
He's not used to landing Gravity Cancel Downlight at 500 damage. You know what I mean? He had that stock cooked and he was ready.
Did you see that Taro signature go crazy?
I mean, this is, we've been wanting Taro signatures.
Not China, that's for sure.
I love that, even though we're seeing a lot of different players play the same legend, we're seeing such distinct play styles here.
Oh yeah,
the
play styles really shine through with these players, especially from the different regions, the top of different regions. And Munir is one good hit away from taking out Luna. Luna abusing these side airs to make it back to the stage. He narrowly avoids getting knocked out. Munir comes with the counterattack and takes the game. 1-0 in favor of Munir. Munir is the player on the right there, next to the Brala.
But now, you can see only one player is enjoying the music. You know what I mean? Munir, you win, you start the jam. He's look at him.
Jamming.
He's relaxed. He's feeling it.
He's
I love
jamming.
This. Okay.
Okay.
Now, we've got maybe my prediction could come true, the double Taros matchup. You know?
Ooh, dude, that would be such a treat to see these two Taros legends.
Because I got to imagine Munir is going to stick with Taros after how much changed
he
the whole time.
Yeah, big time with it. Luna's probably going to want to make some kind of adjustment, right? But Luna's got a few. He's got a few excellent picks in the pocket. Would he actually be so bold as to go for a mirror match after losing?
That's kind of the ultimate. You know, if you're 1v1ing somebody, you're back and forth. The mirror match that decides it all, really.
To do that in game two after losing would definitely destroy your opponent's like any momentum that they had of being like, oh yeah, I got this.
It's
you
the only
pick
answer.
Their legend and delete them, then that would certainly shut them down. I wonder what Luna's picking right now.
You will have
are they talking to each other?
Wait and see. Like I don't know. Yeah, Luna's got. He's making sure everything is perfect and ready.
Oh, as you should.
Doing his due diligence
take great care. This is important.
You can see how relaxed Munir became after game two. You know, he knows that he has this. He has the ability to get a win over Luna, who, again, rank one in North America. That basically means,
that says
you could beat anybody, really, is how you kind of feel.
Yeah.
And if he's feeling that way, again, the confidence is so key in a game like this. So we'll see if he can carry that on into game three. And again, we were playing for the, you know, nobody wants to be last. Nobody wants to be last.
That's the main event.
We can't really say enough to build up how everyone here is a winner. Just by being in a position to get invited, flown out, come to this Royale, you have proven yourself to be one of the best players on the entire planet.
Absolutely. Couldn't have said it better myself. And Steven, the dream is real. We are seeing a Taros mirror match. You absolutely called it out.
Dude,
Here we go.
I feel like Taza the way my predictions are coming true. You know what I mean? That's a good feeling. Here we are. Double Taros.
Double
this is
Taros.
All the beef you could ever want in a single
so
matchup.
Much beef.
Oh, wow. Bifa in every sense of the word on display here in Game 3. Who gets momentum in this set? This is a best of five, so this won't decide it, but this is going to be huge. I mean, scrapping back and forth. The damage basically even. We're seeing twin weapon throws coming through. Nice. There, the stomp sider landed by Luna. Weapon throw off the side of the
edge. That's huge!
My, is he gonna,
he had to do the side light. The sider would not have landed because of how low Munir was when he got that. It's an excellent play from Luna to recognize that in the heat of the moment, and I cannot believe that knockout.
That
must have been the last available pixel in that send.
That was really the most optimal amount of force and damage for that to, to finish off the job there.
One less damage and it wouldn't have knocked out.
The thing is, the juggles from Munir have been going crazy. Once it gets Luna in the air, he starts eating away at those jump options, the dodge options. He is feasting on that stock. So we'll have to see how that develops here in Game 3. But it is a close, heated race. Now that the legends are even, it's only down to the individual player that decides it. And I love to see these two legends. Oh my gosh!
Wait, he could finish him right here.
No, that's
Wow! He knew. Don't chase dead people.
That was a great call from Munir, but also I like a spiteful weapon throw when you know you're dead. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like you might as well get the one damage. Why not? Go for it. Okay, Munir again with the juggles. We're seeing it happening all over.
Yeah, his axe nair game is like top notch.
And the gravity cancel down light. He's not afraid to gravity cancel, which again, you know, players who optimize against being punished sometimes shy away, but he's not that type of player. He goes for the gravity cancel yet again, puts himself in a dangerous situation, but it's also what got him in a winning position like this.
Two sock victory for Munir. He's looking good. Going into Game 4 ahead in the set 2-1, Munir needs only to win one more game to come away with this victory against the number one player of North America. Wouldn't that be nice?
Look at this. Enjoying some nice, refreshing water. Boom. Quenched.
Oh, you see good. That's good water,
He cartoonishly enjoyed that water. That was like, I've never seen anyone more quenched before in my life. Wow. And I mean, after, you know, setting a new record for pace in that third game, Munir deserves it. Luna needs to make some sort of switch up here himself. I mean, the legend swap didn't do it. That only exacerbated the lead that Munir was able to take.
Yeah, and good job by Munir. Munir winning that mirror match was really tantamount to his victory. I don't know what he would have done.
And it's just, again, if somebody tries to mirror match you to, like, get one over on you and you shut them down, that's huge.
That's huge. That's huge. So you can see in Luna's face here, he's wondering what to do next.
I mean, when
and I don't know what the answer is. It wasn't Mordex.
Right.
It wasn't Taros. Maybe he should just change his skin. That's
change.
A different color.
Color swap. Change a weapon skin. I don't know. Change your sidekick. There's a lot of
sidekick,
You can change
people underestimate how much that could help.
I mean, sometimes it's the drip, you know, you got to look good to feel good, to be good, to play good.
It's
so
true, true.
I don't know.
It
we'll
looks
see.
Like Luna's going back to Tai Lung, the Mordex crossover, so the same legend he played in round one of this set.
Which he was. I mean, he did get a win in this set.
Right. It looked good. He's just going to stick with what works. He's not like reaching deep into his pocket to do something else. And that lets you know how serious he is about this matchup here.
But you know what? Munir coming in, he's like, we have everything unlocked on these tournament builds. They can do any drip they would like. And yet Munir representing
default Taros.
Showing.
There's unreleased items in this build. He could be playing.
That's true.
He could be playing anything.
Yeah, there's Queen Nye's sword. What a fantastical imaginary thing that they have access to. Won't even pick it up.
You actually can buy Queen Knight's sword in Mahala right now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the jade.
Oh,
the
we put
jade
it in?
Weapon set. That is Queen Knight's sword from
back. It's existed for so many years, I didn't know we ever put it out.
It's secretly in there, yeah. It's like a Easter egg.
Well, all right. Well, there's a little news update for everybody there. Check that out.
On sale now in Mahala. Everybody go buy it.
All right, but this game is important. Munir needs this win to take the victory over Luna. Luna needs it to stay in the set. He gets knocked off. First stock yet again goes to Munir.
We talked about efficient knockouts in the match before, and that was another one, man. I feel like just one less damage, and that wouldn't have knocked out in that particular situation. It's such an efficient knockout. Now Munir's got the stock lead. Can he build up a damage lead while he's got this lead? Now Luna, one good hit away. How's he? Okay, yeah,
Sider's
one more. One more of those will do it.
Oh, okay.
He's trying to catch him off the side. Woo! Yes, fully equalized Luna before taking any damage at all on that second stock. takes Mounir down to his second stock, ties it up.
All right, Mounir, back with the axe in hand. He's been performing so well with this weapon.
Oh,
okay, I was reading the reverse downlight. Weapon throw, we've been seeing a lot of that from his playstyle, but seeing him land some there has been nice. Swaps out now for the hammer. And again, you know, the weapon throws can cost you, because now unarmed against Luna's Scythe is not a position you want to be in. Oh, just barely escapes.
Maybe he doesn't mind, though. Maybe Mounir's actually cool with that.
Okay.
But it worked out well. Nice weapon throw.
That was a good weapon Side throw. That was
can
a good
he get the
throw.
Unarmed edge guard against Luna? He covers himself with a weapon throw, but Mounir rearms himself with the hammer just in time. Throws away the axe. Wait, what's he going to end up with? Okay, he's going axe. He's going axe. And again, we're in this position where Mounir's got the stock lead, and we're looking for a damage lead. He can build one up here against Luna, but Luna seems to always manage to just equalize the stocks in
time.
That
was such a beautiful read for the turnaround stomp.
Yeah.
Okay, but it didn't. He got a bit of damage on that final stock of Luna. Gives him a slight lead coming into this final lap, but Luna has the speed to maybe pull away with it.
He needs it. This is the stock here. This is a tournament stock for Luna.
One
and he is down by a lot.
Yeah, against the Taros, this is
Luna.
Tough situation.
He's got to win this. He's got to bring this around right now, or Mounir's going to come away with his first victory of the round! There it is! Against number one North America, Mounir's got what it takes!
Wow.
Oh, man! Fist bump. What a powerful fist bump.
I mean, if you're going to take one win in the Royale, what a big victory.
That's the one to get. Let's go, Mounir.
Excellent work.
0-6.